And now let's take a look at logic modules. In alive forms, we can create logic units and we can apply a logic unit that is created on multiple forms. And a form can have multiple logic units. So if we go to logics from here or from menu, open logics, let's create our first logic unit. Click on this button to create a new logic unit and apply, or we can also select already created logic units and click on apply. We can apply up to 10 logic units at the moment, and then we need to press apply. Or we can create a new logic and apply, and if we are in form editor, we can open dashboard and click on new logic, and it will create and apply logic on open form. So here we have two choices. Do you want a logic unit for local or server? First, we look at the local logic units. So name it, let's say it is called T1, and here is the logic editor. A logic is basically a set of conditions. It can have a no code condition. It can also have JavaScript code. So to add a condition, click on add condition button. And since it is designed in a modular way, so this is not strictly attached to a specific form. So we can select a form according to which we are going to create a logic. And if form structures are compatible, such as we are running a logic on every screen, or let's say screen indexes match the structure, we can reuse this logic unit again and again and save our time. And we can design our logic units such that we can apply on multiple forms. For the tutorial, let's say we want to show a message based upon the rating. So if input of screen, now screen index, we can have all, we can run it on all screen indexes, we can run it before form loads, and this is very useful when we are using JavaScript logic to bootstrap our form. We can run when form is submitted and result is loaded, or we can select one or more indexes individually. So give rating screen, we select this index, and if the rating or the input of screen index 5, the rating question is less than 4, that is like 3, 2, or 1, we show a message that is alert message, and the message can be we will imp, and that's it. From actions, we have many actions, those we can select according to our needs, and then we have parameters for those actions, those can be one or more. Now let's repeat it for if input is more than 4 or equal to 4. Click on add, and if input of screen 5, and we need to remove it, so put cursor here and remove it. We can manually enter our screen 2 like this. So screen 5, and select operation. If it is greater than or equal to 4, then add action and select action alert and message. The argument is going to be thank you, and save it. Now let's open our form. I can click quickly open my form by opening desk, and from here I open my form. If is more than 4 or equal to 4, we see thank you message. I go back, from here I select 3, and we see the different message. So that's how our no code logic works. And this was for the client side. Now I want to show the server side logic. So what I can do here, I can either create logic from here, or I can open my logics section And while I am managing my logics here, I can create a new logic from here. So let's say it is called server logic. The title is T2, for example. And this is server logic here. And now we have different ifs options and different actions depending upon the type. So let's say if input of screen, and now let's select our form, and from here give a rating, and let's say if rating is greater than values to match, let's say it is 4 or 3, like 4 or 5. So we add action that is, let's say, redirect. We redirect user to this website and we save it. So let's go back to our form editor. If in the desk we have our form opened, I can edit the form. And I go to logics section, and from here I select and click on apply, and let's fill the form again. And after form is submitted, we are going to be redirected to the website after this timer ends. So that was the server logic. And why we need two types of logic system, that is something you need to keep in mind. If there is an interactivity such as calculation, those are not very crucial. You can do it on user device. But if there is some activity that must be performed on server, such as calculation that is for academic tests, etc., you can perform those actions on the server. And also make sure to read AliveForms docs about logic system. That will be very helpful. Okay, so after that, let's have a first taste of JavaScript in our logic units. For this tutorial, I'm going to just edit our existing logic, and here I'm going to add another condition. And that is going to be execute JavaScript, and execute it after this one when user enters the name. I want to show the message welcome and then name. Now here one thing you need to remember: when we are executing the JavaScript, it will be executed right after when user presses the next button, and after that the JavaScript is executed. If you want to execute JavaScript on other occasions, such as on back button press or screen entering, you can use event handlers provided by JavaScript API or special functions provided by JavaScript API. You can read more about them in this special function docs or these event handler docs on AliveForms docs. Okay, so back to our logic. Here, what we want to do is just call JavaScript API, and JavaScript API is called by using dollar sign. And in JavaScript API, we have detailed information on that in that page, and our JavaScript unit has access to these variables. So input is the input of current screen, inputs is the array, and weights is the weight point. Those are accumulated by a screen, and screen is the index of screen on which logic is performed. Upload is access to files uploaded by users, and dollar is the AliveForms API object. So we call, let's say, dollar dot alert, and it needs a single argument. So we can say hello. If I save it and I refresh the form by going back here, and now when I enter my name, I see hello. Let's say I want to show the name that was entered by user. So what I can do is I'm going to use a string interpolation, and here I write the input variable and I refresh the form. I do it again, and here I have access to the input. And I can also do same by using inputs and passing the index screen that was 1 at the moment. So refresh it, and same thing here. Or I also can pass a constant number. So that's how it is done. Okay, and now let me show you another thing, event handling. Event handling is very, very useful. For example, let's say on this screen, if user says yes or no, when user clicks, we want to show some message. Okay, here I'm going to use this event handling function. So what we can do is we can use this syntax. So I'm going here, I'm going to add a condition, and this event handling is going to be implemented on boot screen. We can create a complete logic just from boot screen by using special function or event handling. So let's say we handle what function, and another thing is that we can run this in a loop, and we can increment index for screen number and perform a very powerful logic that can cover multiple situations. Okay, so here is the event. So we have screen, that screen index number and input change, and we pass a function as arguments. And in that function, we don't have access to input, but inputs array. And we also need to hard coded provided a number or a number from loop, as I explained, or from other variable, but we don't have access to screen variable. So here, since I'm going to perform it on this, I see the index from that dropdown, that is 2. I'm not going to press it. And let's say screen 2 input change, and we pass the argument function. Okay, so when the input is changed, what I need to do is I just show a message that your option was this. So first I'm going to use another option that is called parse string from JavaScript API. It can parse the string provided in AliveForms syntax template. So from here, let's say let txt is dollar dot parse string, and we are going to provide it screen dot 2, and then we alert text. So that's it. And we can also use if and else if statement, like if inputs and the index is equal to that, perform that, those things. Okay, let's check the form. Here, now if I say yes, it is selected yes, and no, it says no. So that was the first test of JavaScript and event handling. That's it for the video, and thank you for watching the video.